Hodgkin and Burcham continued with the installation and development and improvement of the 10-centimetre air interception equipment in the Blenheims and then the Beaufighters. And I was given another job, and that was to make an advanced air interception system in which the paraboloid scanner would lock onto its target, an enemy, and could be done by blind firing. Well, I worked on that, and I had the great help of F.C. Williams, who was another electronics expert who had wide-ranging applications in TRE, telecode, as we were then called, TRE, the Telecommunications Research Establishment. And F.C. Williams was particularly good on this. We devised them. I think I originally had a system from Metropolitan-Vickers in which the I could lock the echo and so the scanner would lock itself onto the echo. And I had this system going up to many, many flights from this bumpy airfield at Christchurch with F.C. Williams and another colleague called Ritson. And we had a good system, not working quite reasonably well by the end of 1941. I had one interesting problem. That is the fading, the high-speed fading of the echo from a target aircraft. And you see, we were using pulses, radar pulses of 1,000 a second or thereabouts. And the high-speed fading, we had somehow to cope with this because it was disturbing the lock follow. And I began to build high-speed camera so that we could analyse the what was happening with this high-speed fading. And Blackett, he then frequently came to see how we're getting on. He had then been, I think he was first of all scientific advisor to General Pike of the AA Command, and then Coastal Command, and later on the Director of Naval Operational Research in the Admiralty. But He frequently came to see how we were getting on. And one day he said, "What are you doing?" And I said, "I'm making a high-speed camera to study the fading of the pulses from a target aircraft." And he said, "Oh." He said, "Well, you know, I think I've got a young man who might be able to help you." Now, this is a remarkable story. A few days later, Andrew Huxley arrived. Now, Andrew Huxley was another of these brilliant young Cambridge people, a physiologist. And Andrew Huxley said he'd come to help. And I said, "Oh, where's your equipment?" He said, "Oh, he pulled a Leica camera out of his pocket." And I said, "What are you going to do?" He said, "It's easy." He said, "I've taken away the lens. I'm going to put this in front of the cathode treble. I'm going to do that to the film." And so that happened. Now, those original records are now with many of my own papers and records in the archives in the Imperial War Museum. And you can see, It just worked. He did this. And that from that we were able to analyse. The pulses were separated, of course, one by one by one. No problem in analysing the type of fluctuations which were occurring. That's an interesting sideline. Huxley, again, this brilliant scientist, Master of Trinity, Nobel Prize winner, President of the Royal Society, and he's still a friend. I still see him occasionally in London. but I'm sure he's forgotten that episode. Anyhow, I was about to, I had arranged to get a bow fighter and to make arrangements to have this lock follow blind firing equipment manufactured properly and installed in a squadron of bow fighters.